Okay, evening, folks. We're playing some Flint Hook tonight. I'm not starting from the beginning by any means. I've been playing this game pretty much every day, and I suck at it every single day, but it's so much fun. I keep coming back to it every single day. So, hop right in here. I'm going to start out with the first level. I'm not going to do the tutorial, but at least this way, everyone starts together. Oh. Booster pack from last time I played. Each level up gets me more cards that I can use. Dan's here. Hey, Dan. I'm just gonna hop right in. Like I said, I'm not the greatest at the game, but I just enjoy it. How's tonight going for you, bud? The whole premise behind this game is most of your movement skills is dependent on your grappling hook. Frost Glow and Frozen. So those two, that's a sub-weapon that I can't afford yet. But as soon as I can, I'm going to come back and get it. You get sexier with every day, don't you, buddy? Except for now. So I'm pretty sure there's an achievement or... you get something special if you can get through two rounds unscathed. Let's just say I have never been anywhere near that accomplishment. And Nick is here. Nick's phone doesn't like me. Every time I'm streaming, it shits the bed. Slow-mo feature. Helpful sometimes when you can get the hang of it. Unless, you know, you hop into the enemy. Then it doesn't really matter. Ah, shit. So, Dan, you put any more thought into streaming the weekend? So, I'm gonna go back up to the store. There's a little bit of backtracking to the game, but nothing too serious. Maybe that's part of the reason why I like it a little more is, womp womp, Dan with the funnies. It's kind of got that little Castlevania feel to it. And I'm a sucker for Castlevania. Of the Metroidvania style, I should say. Not so much the older stuff. Oh, you are doing Sunday night? You're doing Destiny? So one thing about this game is the sub-weapons, you only get one shot use out of them. So for the most part, I hardly ever use them. Should probably stop doing that and actually use them, or at least
get used to them with the boss. Oh, Rise and Shine. That looks like a fun game that Nick would swear a lot at, so. Are you gonna swear at it a lot? I hope so. The anger will be too much to handle. Pointy walls are pointy. I don't have a key yet. So this must be the boss fight. No, I do have a key. I'll be going back. You're right on time. Been approximately 7 whole minutes and I went right past where I was going. Boom. I'm gonna swear, scream, and cry. Sounds like a regular night for you. HP at least. So I said I was going to use that sub-weapon for the boss, and I never did. Yeah, look at that. Never leave home without blowing up everything around. That was my old favorite sub-weapon, but now I'm going to try out the freezer ball. Smash. Well, you get in the heat of the moment and you just pew 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 with your blaster and you don't think about it. But maybe as I get more sub weapons, I'll use them more often. So in the bottom left-hand corner of each of those Polaroids, there's a number next to a skull. The higher the number, the more my ass gets kicked. I haven't played this yet today, so I'm a little behind on it, but, you know, had to do those other fatherly duties by caring for children and all those other excuses. Dan's gotta go take a poop. Shit. Ah. Yeah, not here for any awards by any means. Watch it for the pointy floor.
What?
Shoot all the bag. Oh, shit.
What?
Approval stamp. Relics are just a collectible that you watch out for. You can usually buy them or find them in chests like I just did, obviously. I get a little more brave with my time slowing ability as I continue on. The bloom. So some of the platforms you can shoot through, but not all of them. Most of the enemies can shoot through all of them. So you got to keep yourself on your toes. It's no protection for you, or for the most part, except, you know, like crates and things like that, where it's obvious protection. These guys don't really do anything. They're just there to get in my way, and I usually just run into them. Oh shit! Four times, not five, or not three. So if you hold the top left shoulder button, you can hold in place, shoot around. The actual gorilla is back, so I'm gonna try my sub weapon here. And of course, that doesn't benefit me because now he's frozen and I can't do it, except, you know, I will jump into his attacks. So that's the kind of guy I am. Yeah, I'm never gonna get that achievement. Take no damage. One more shot. Boom. Now to fully backtrack. My own fault. I froze him. So one day we can rebuild him. I do really enjoy the soundtrack of this game. It's somewhat repetitive, but it goes by different levels, different stage levels and whatnot, so it changes up with the next time around. Coinage. Boom, boom, boom. These are time locks. You bounce off them, unless you use your time belt, and you zoom right through. Your bullets can penetrate them regardless. Yeah, I get a real Mega Man feel for it too. This guy eats books. Because, you know, that's normal. More collectibles. Ghost ships. It's pixel art 2.0, I think. Not that that's a term, but it should be. And if it becomes a term, I penned it and I want royalties. All of them. So you don't necessarily have to backtrack. But I like to cover all the map. There are some secret rooms that you can come across. I haven't seen any yet, though. Oop. And there's places that just explode. Do-do-do-do-do-do. I buy these all up just because. Each game you play, you start out with some permanent perks, and these perks that you pick up in-game, where you pick up in-game, whether you buy them or you get them out of the chest, they're just for this playthrough. The queue for the secret room is... Oh, shit. Not that. Or that. In the sides, there's grates like these, but the one that's the hidden room has a skull on it. There's one actually in the before the first boss fight, and it's like a secret dev room. Oh, I don't need that. I already have it. Pepper shot. Put some gusto in your pistol, increase your power for critical blasts. Pew pew! So I don't think every level has a secret room, but I found a few of them. It's usually, you know, just more money and chests and stuff. So it's all good. Oh, I'm sure there's a bunch of weapon perks that you can get through the game. I'm currently at a rank of 28, I think. And I know that there's a lot. I'm with the higher ranks and whatnot, you get higher shot power, and you can pretty much customize your own character to any extent. So now it's my turn. Time to leave. Move on to the next ship. Oh, I guess I need to play more. I always do the shooty shoots. So each of those green gems that pop up in the bottom left-hand corner, it's currency at the black market where you can buy upgrades and different things along those lines. It's a very versatile game. I don't know. So each of the ships have a different description. Like platoon on board, I'm guessing there's a lot of enemies. Labyrinthine, just big map. Gauntlet, lots of enemies in one room. I'm gonna go with Labyrinthine. Yeah, I gotta buy more experience boosting items. I think I have 3 or 4 right now. But I sometimes go back to this earlier level like I did right now to grind out, get a few more gems. So there's a bunch of enemies that don't really attack, so if I'm smart, I won't get hit. Let's see how smart I am. Except that guy. He shoots, so take him out first. Treasure chest in front of the saw blade. Always fun. No, it's really not that tough to control. There's a learning curve to it. Because you've got to get used to, one control stick controlling both of your movement and your gun, but you can hold the top left shoulder button and you can move yourself, your shots around. Thank you. There's always hidden little tricks here, like the floors are going to explode now. I want the monies. If you're quick enough, which apparently I'm not, you can get through that. So bubble enemies like that, you have to use your hook on. And, you know, dodge the other enemies as well. This guy throw knives, which I should dive right into. Shit. Oh well. Continue going up. So I want that item, so I'm gonna have to fight this particular guy's group of enemies. He's, you know, just a NPC, but if I want that, I have to fight for it. Which of course I do. And now there's more guys on the other side. Shit. Oh, I thought I was going to get through that one. Can I spoof it? I can. Boop, boop. Baha. Wasn't so smart the second time around. Yeah, the first boss I know was really difficult to get through. Hey, Dan. Because there's so many grappling hooks. The bubble is impenetrable to gunshots, but not to your hooker. It's one of those hookers with a heart of gold thing, Julia Roberts. Now, I see, like, from what I see, a lot of people have trouble with this guy. I'm going to use my sub-weapon. Ah. Because he just shoots a steady stream of lasers. Unless you do that to him. Otherwise, he will follow you around the room relentlessly. Now I'm going to backtrack again. Oh, goody. I got to go back up through that. Anytime you get a book, gain more firepower following a strong combo. Yeah, we'll see how gotta get to that. Yeah, it's a bit of a cheater weapon, but it's helpful in those situations where it's a single form boss. Go back around.
I'm on the website.
It's no cheater locket, but it'll have to do. Shit. Trap. Good timing. So all your money and your health and whatnot, it carries over from one section to the next. So what I don't spend here or lose here in the way of health, I'll carry over into the next. Oh, damn it. I'm gonna die. Getting out of there. Well, that was fun. I'm not gonna make it out of this level now. Maybe I will. Pick up a shield, that'll take one hit for me, and grab an apple that gives me 10 health. I have no doubt in my mind that you would, Nick. Then your minion would get up at 6 and you would hate yourself. Shit. Oh, good. So, Pirate Zing, that's going to add 10 HP, I believe. Sharpshooter, I'm going to grab this first, because Space Meat gives me health. Sharpshooter. Critical hit possibles. For when you finally pass out at night. Just give in, go to sleep. I don't believe I have enough money for this one. Nope, 400. I'm sure this would be great on the Switch. Or... I haven't had a chance to experience a Switch as of yet, so... Just seeing all the hype is really good, though. I really love Nintendo, so... Well, at least I'm getting back through with 55 health. It's coming in my next purchase. Oh shit! Good thing I had that shield. Would have liked to keep it. Ah! Oh. Remember that thing I told you about traps and not to jump on them? I should take my own advice. Apparently. Oh well. At least this is the end. Get some health back. Smash this clam, if you know what I mean. So now I can take on the first boss. At least there's some health in the opening. And away we go. So, Nick, I'll show you the first secret room, at least. So, first, pop this, eat that. Money, 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 money. Secret room, skull. You can just use your normal attack. Now, I'm guessing these are all developers. It's pretty cool. But at the end, it's almost like there's something I can do, but I haven't really looked into it. So, pay tribute to the ancients and come sail away. 3 days port, 3 nights starboard, travel up and down, north and south, throw away your possessions and leap into the air. Heave ho, there she goes, the song of Black Margot. So I'm guessing each of these... There's something I can do here, but... Little icon. Yeah, the visual indicator is nice. Kind of like the cracked wall in Zelda games. So, in the opening, it says, he never blinks. The unblinking leader. But I just saw him blink twice. He's a blinking bastard. More health. So this guy, you've got to pop his ass bubble. But with the amount of grappling hooks in here, it's difficult to lock onto just one. And then these SpongeBob Patrick Star bastards, every time you pop his tail, he creates two. The first time I played through this, I didn't have a certain upgrade for my weapon, so it took two shots. Oh. Pew. I'm getting the hang of the time slowing down part, at least. Sometimes. Shit. There's a ricochet shot that you can get to that's really helpful. See, that's sometimes what happens. So, I'm probably not going to last this round. I've only got 15 health left. Maybe I should stop focusing on the money, he says as he gets more money. Pew pew. So close. So close. Only one more phase left. Damn it. I died. But now I get my experience. Oh, I should go back. Check out my relics. Hard to get stamp of approval, and you have it. Please use only with Octopod Ink. So that's a Nintendo reference to Splatoon, I'm assuming. So I got none of these things. Let's go for experience boosters. Six. I don't think I can get anything for three. Well, we'll go right back in. Critical blast chances match the number of your combo hits. Start up again. Treasurarium. Visiting a shrine, beware of the emerald stones. I don't have any money for you yet, buddy. 20. 160. Fast blast makes my shots move faster. Makes a lot more playthroughs. Bastards. The bubbles. shoot you in the butt. What in the butt? Key. Shoot the bubble. Yep, every bubble, whatever color it is, you've got to shoot it with your hooker shot. Pop the bubble, and then they're vulnerable. Go back up to the shop. Yeah, when you're jumping on the Kremlins and whatnot. Ooh! Ooh! Kremlings, not Kremlins, that's different. Now we're gonna go straight down. Boom! Of course. The timing's off. Boom. DK Donkey Kong. Now in this case, even the platforms are going to hurt me. They've got knives on them. Shit. See? Like that. I had to demonstrate. Learn by example. Boom. Go down first, and then I'll go up and get all those collectibles. Place is haunted, it has a big purple booger in it. So in this case, the red bubbles are made by magic. I have to get rid of him first. And, you know, take all those shots. So this is actually the boss room for this area, so now I have to go back. Timer room. An apple, shield, probably gonna need it. Oh, so Nick, you're gonna be streaming tomorrow night now instead? B. Ooh, that was close. You plan on switching it up, or are you doing more Laura? Crafty craft. Oh yeah, we should finish her off. Rest is needed. You got the little one, and she's up at whatever time she wants to get up. The changing of the seasons and the sun. That sun thing really wakes him up in the morning. Even blackout blinds don't always work. For them to come to me. Go up first. No, maybe not. They're everywhere. But they gave me money. Extra HP. Extra HP. Potion, I don't need that yet. Well, we're in the Maritimes, we hardly get any sun, so why would we need it now? So he got my shield. I'm not here to depress anyone, but, you know, it is what it is. Makes us cry a little more often. Who needs happiness, really? Full health. So this is moments of being tough. But it's really rewarding, because you know, when you die, you know you're going to get your experience that you accumulated through the level, and then you're going to feel a little bit better because you're going to be a little bit stronger. And this is what my other sub-weapon does. You know, completely miss every aspect of the enemy. That's cool. Damn it. Yeah, I played a little bit of Roguelike. See, I didn't enjoy it as much as I enjoy this. I found myself dying a lot more on that. But maybe that's just how it's designed. To kick your ass. At least this way it feels like it likes me playing with it. one was so puckered it exploded. I still haven't gone back to listen to my recordings. Should probably take your advice and do that, though. Shit. It's the only part that I don't like about this game is some of the aiming aspects. This is a bitch. You got the platinum? Well, congratulations to you. I don't remember the last time I played a game to completion. Giving all my games blue balls. Maybe one of these days. Maybe this game. It's easy to get the hang of it, but it's also frustrating when it doesn't go. It's like, that's not where I aimed. Death door, so when I'm low on health, power increases. Now I'm done with the backtracking at least. I'll never take your warning shots away from you, Nick. It's always yours. I'm pretty close to completion with Isaac, but there's a lot of little nitpicky side quests that I really don't care for doing. Like, there's one challenge where you go through and you only collect keys or, you know, stupid little shit like that. I just don't have time for it. Lately, I've just been playing games for fun, not so much for the completion of it, I guess. Well, except for, I replayed Metroid Fusion and Metroid... Oh, what's the other one? Oh, brain fart. Anyway, the GBA Metroids. Metal Whale. Zero Mission, thank you. I knew you'd know it. And the thing about you can't go to the black market whenever you want, it's frustrating, but it's also understandable why it's that kind of game mechanic, is you're trying to get through with what you've earned between missions. So, you know, you just quit your bitching and do it. I haven't even played Metroid Prime since that time I streamed it that one night. Should really go back and give that some love. No, I don't need to do this yet because I do not have a key. So, Nick, is it difficult to stream from your PS4, or is it pretty easy compared to, say, running OBS from your PC? You know, if I started doing that, it would give me a little more gameplay aspects. That I really got a lot of games on my PS4 to play on stream, but at the same time, it'd be more than what I have now. I've already got it connected to Steam and whatnot, so. Poof. Coins. How did they share about me? Ah. Warning shots, warning shots. I don't get any warning shots, they all hit me. I can deal with 5 seconds of work. Health is good. May just add it to my streaming collection that I have going on in here in the basement. For all the fun and good times. Ah, damn it. I already have that one. That's just another relic. Oh. Stare of the Mist. Mist is Taco Bell farts. I don't need another potion. I didn't look to see if anything down there was. Nope, no secret rooms. Nope, didn't wait. Nope. Damn it. Good thing there's a potion back there for me to get. Ugh, boy. Brings the Jewish out in me. You just bought this one? It's really fun. And I like that it's a Canadian developer. Space meat. Yeah. Who doesn't like space meat in the mouth? Oh! I suck. I should really stop doing that. Or, you know, I should do it a couple more times. Oh, perfect. Oy. I'm gonna die doing this. This is gonna be on my tombstone. Already have that one. Galactic Light. Tumble Seed. I haven't heard of that one. I saw Wanda Switch. If nothing else, for the next, Steam Dig. Why am I having such a hard time remembering game names tonight? Oh, right. I got Severed on the Vita. It was part of the PSN free games. Of course, I gobbled that right up. I'm gonna buy this potion. Here we go. Run, run. I'll take Severed to my next trip to the washroom. I promise. I wonder if they realize the innuendo that they've placed when you're smashing the space clam. Look, it's time to go fight the bath battle again. Bad Billy Bullseye. Numb thighs and the red ring of death around my ass. I've been there. They introduced a game mechanic there again to make sure you realize that bubbles pop with your hooker. Blink. Blink. Oh, I guess he got one eye, so he's winking. So maybe he doesn't blink because he only winks. Oh, I wasn't trying to eat that meat. I gotta kill off those starfish before they overwhelm me. Shit. Beep, beep, beep. Probably his brother or something. Ah, shit. Yeah, I should just jump right into him. Fuck. Makes the most sense. Shoot, shoot. Bang, bang. So he's got 53 health, but I believe it's two more attacks. And starfish. Cheater shot. The first time I beat this guy, the bullets came out after the fact, after I beat him, and killed me. So close, I was so mad. Son of a bitch. So that's what it looks like to beat the first boss. Oh, it made me so very angry. Smash, 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 smash. Gold feathers. So now the next section takes you to a different quadrant, I'm guessing. So the aesthetics are a bit different. I don't blow up his ship. This time. Level 30. You get a lot of experience. Adds up quickly, thankfully. So I've got 12. That takes 12. Buy these two, which gives me more experience per black market item and per relic I found. Doing pretty good, so next time around I will see if I can't get the cluster clans putting those up to catch you, but it gives you a heaping of XP. Maybe I should have got that one. Oh well. I don't know if there is a level cap as of yet. Fabian, I think it's Fabian that said that he's at 55. Oh. There must be something new. We still got a thing, an Astra Silver. Oh. Take on gold feathers. Moody Prospector. Find more gold when you break stuff. Your pistol gains more firepower as your health gets lower. Bullseye. Get more chance of hitting a critical blast. Pepper shot. So I'm not going to change anything here for this time around. Platoon on board. Platoon on board. Percival. So Percival means a lot of money. So it's a 2 on the old Dangeroo scale. But let's go. Music here is a little more hoppy jumpy. Bastard. Take this. Boom boom birds. Now, I don't know if at some point these come into play because it's, you know, marked with a skull like the secret doors. Now, these give me gold and extra health. I'm going to go with the extra health. Oh, this guy gives me a map. Let's talk to him. I see you cannot resist the appeal of a good map, friend. Neither can I. Pick up shield, so my next hit won't affect me. Pick up the skulls. Just can't touch the tips of those or they'll hurt me. I'm not gonna pop those drums because sometimes they have the purple ghosts in them. That's gross. See, like that. Might as well show with an example. So no key yet. So that means more backtracking later. Which I'm really okay with. This is my pre-boss battle. Chickaboos. There goes my shield. Boom. The key. So I guess it's not terrible backtracking. Getting in here was easy. Getting out won't be so much. The map kind of looks like a key. Now it's boss battle time. Still get hit. And when I get hit with those little balls of electricity, I can't use my gun for a few seconds. Just kind of a cool little add-on in there, I think. kind of a piss off, but at the same time, you're getting punished for being an idiot. As is life. Sometimes the sub-weapon pops up right under the clam, so you gotta wait, or you gotta jump over the sub-weapon in order to get the clam. I think I'm gonna try to do a little bit of fan art with this one of these days. They seem very complex yet simple to draw. Afraid of Devil's Lodge. Danger Room. Rock Tumble. I don't know what Devil's Lodge is. Yeah, bullshit paralysis sometimes. But at the same time, you are punished for your mistakes and you get the extra bonus if you don't get hit by it. By, you know, not losing health or the use of your gun. I want money. I want to do a picture of Flint Hook meeting Hollow Knight, because I feel like they're aesthetically close, except Hollow Knight is a stag beetle, but he's still got the white head. And I feel like they would get along. I'm not gonna write any fanfic, over it. But I just feel like they could exist. Flint Hook is in space. Hollow Knight is not in space. Oh shit. Boom. I feel like it could do with a range upgrade. Of course. Die already. Looks like I'm getting away from that other room, so I'm going to backtrack now ahead of time to try and alleviate some time later without jumping into the acid pits. Now, let's find that room. Or, to hop into the spikes. In the back, next room. So tonic gives me full HP. Oh shit, I'm on 5. I wish I could afford it. Did I miss anything that I could get coins from? Potion will have to do. Didn't realize I was so low on health. Close. see if I can do this without dying. That'd be great. That last room really took the shit out of me. So let's just ride this over. I wish you had a charge feature a la Mega Man. I guess it would probably be too close to Mega Man for him to be able to charge his shots. But then again, there could be something later on that I don't know about. Health. Oh, shit. Oh, this looks fun. Boom! Okay, so timing is everything. Increase your chances of finding sub-weapons. Oh, you bitch. Oh, damn it. Concussion. Oh. Curse of the Draining Battle. Gain more XP but lose HP the longer you stay in battle rooms. Worrying. Huh. That's interesting. You're already shielded when boarding a ship. So that'll carry on to the next ship, but it won't carry on to the next run. This guy's cool. I want to get a screenshot of him. Can I get a screenshot of him? Well, we'll see what happens. So I see I have 14 viewers, or 4 viewers right now. Happy to have you here, by the way. Do a little more, a few more shout outs to the peeps in the chat. Battalion on board, gambling here. Rumble room. Twirlington territory. I'm gonna play it safe and go with the 2. Dude, I love Deathspank. I played the shit out of all three games. I actually fired up my PS3 the other day. Well, not the other day. It's probably a few weeks ago now. Just so I could play some Death Bank. Oh. Sure. Be tough. Become more resistant to enemy damage. I'm rubbing my hands. Just thinking of gambling in general. Love it. Whatever you do behind closed doors, I want no part of the dude. I would love for there to be another Death Bank game. Something up-res for the PS4. Oh. I would so stream Death Bank. I played them all. They're really repetitive because it's the same game over and over, pretty much. The storyline changes a little bit. There's a lot more weapons and equipment and whatnot, but the Baconing. I think the Baconing was the third. I don't remember the titles anymore. This was one of those games that I instantly fell for. Kind of like this one. It really was. The storyline was humorous. It was just a fun game. So now I have to get rid of all these guys before I can, or the mage looking guys before I can take on the red bubbles. Put my sub weapon, see if I can't make some hits. God damn those things. If I had a capture card, I think I would definitely do some Death Bank. That's a cam girl. Death Spanking is something completely different in that world. Pretty sure. Hero to the downtrodden. I don't think he got the love he deserved. The tick. Spoon! Range up. Oh damn, I don't have enough money for some space meat. Now I do. Sweet. Sweet, sweet space meat. But when you speak of the tick, do you mean live action or cartoon tick? Because I find them very different. Slow down time, why look at maps even longer, friend, such is the way. Yeah, I got a map for the last four parts of the ship. Cartoon, okay, good. Then we are on the same page. As much as I enjoy Patrick Warburton, he doesn't compare to the cartoon tick. Jump, 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 jump. Damn. Best catch trade ever. Spoon! With his trusty sidekick, Arthur. That didn't work out so well. Well, at least I don't have to backtrack this time around. It really is. Boom! Oh. Feeding my goo compass. One more ghost gem and I can go to the boss. Oh, they're all fours. Danger room, fog full, broken map, platoon on board. Platoon on board, platoon on board, doom, sanctuary, chopping block. I'm gonna go with danger room and fog full because the rest of it just scares the bejesus out of me. Okay, just a second here. Put on a movie for the children's. Bitch is haunted. These guys suck. Ah. Huzzah! Oh, this bastard again. On a treasure, better be ready for a fight, short stuff. Bring it on. Oh god. Play this right. That wasn't it. Pirate's Vigor, pick up. You're in rude health by adding. Ooh, that's 25 more health points. Super. Pirate's Deal. Get special deals and shops for you, the Valiant Pirate. Except that. I can't get that. So space meat, which is usually 120, is now 119. Bastard. I'm gonna have to go back to that room. Pop up my skulls. Jump into the rocket. Oh, this sucks. Another thing that I'm going to have to go through again. Sure, run into him. Hits. I hope there's some health in that thing. Go back down. I don't think I'm going back for that other room. I don't think it's worth my time. I think I'm going to die if I do. Malfact. game is the knees of bees. But I feel like the knees of the bees have been shot off. Damn. Yeah, I got 12 health. And this is not a shop. If anything, it's the opposite of a shop. Maybe this is a shop. It is a shop. Potion. Okay, so that gave me 50 health. Good times. I only want to travel by hookshot from now on. Oh, secret room back there. Shield. Monies. Bomb. Is there health in this one? Oh, thanks, Nick. You always know what to say to put me in a good mood. Oh. Bitches. I can't get them. There's no mages in there that I can destroy. So they were just impenetrable. Yeah, I'm gonna use this again. Suck it. Oh, so close. And Dan's still here too? I thought you left me. So this is my first time getting this far. So now I have to take on the boss. Golden feathers. Get that scoundrel. He'll never know what hit him. I'm sure I'm going to find out what's going to hit me. I'll try not to die. At least I was still with you in spirit, Dan. Where are we going? Huh. Of course.
I'm down with my gems.
A little bit of health. Goes a long way. Here we go. Oh, he seems like a twat. Okay, so rocks hurt. Oh, gotta get underneath them. feel like using that freeze. May have not have been a good idea. Probably should have kept it for this battle. Jump into it. Oh, yeah, I'm not. Fuck. I died! Oh, well. More levels. More trying again. So I only have 5. I don't think I can buy anything. Nope. So back, play. Hop right into gold feathers again. Oh, don't die. No wonder I was confused. I think I did alright for the first shot at him. I can tell just from how each of them ramp up that I'm sure it's going to be quite the ordeal for the next one. Is it just the 3 bosses? Gangbang. Only time I've never played Overcooked, but I watched Nick play it. It was fun times. Oh. That was not good times. I don't got no money. Electro balls. Oop.
Come on.
back to this other room, see if it leads. Oh wait, I can't. I don't have a key yet. Enjoy the naked boobness. Kisses and hugs. Video games and boobs. Oh, traps. Okay, now I'm gonna back. Shit. I think I'll go until 11 and just call it for the night anyway. My kids are still awake, so might want to get them to bed. But it's the weekend.
Daddy, watch me try to catch my blanket.
Backtrack over this way. Ooh, map. Yeah, they have some late nights on the weekends. Last weekend, last Saturday night, they were awake until midnight. Fabian has multiple personalities. They're down here in the basement with me and watching the movies, so. No hearts. As long as you're not dead to him, you're okay. You heartless bastard. You'll be all right. Bazaars. Money to spend that I don't have. Go down first.
Sugar. Sugar.
Maybe I should go up first. Thanks for coming out though, bud. Even though we're abandoning you. And I just unleashed the ghost. Wizard. So tomorrow night, Nick is streaming. Not quite sure what time yet. Usually he's in the 9:30 vicinity. Monday, I might try to do... I've been doing Tuesday, but I think I need to up my game and stay out of the green stuff. So I might stream some more. I also have Minish Cap going on, aside from this, for streaming. Love me some Minish Cap. Nick might surprise us all with a little bit earlier. Not doing so hot on this run. But I'm sure he'll update when he's going to be streaming on his Twitter, and of course I will share it and stroke the proverbial edict. Virtual handies for everyone. Oh yeah, there we go. Level 35! At least leveling up is easy enough in this game. Anagraph statue depicting the block-breaking form of a wizard orb practitioner. Yeah, I'm going to head off now too. So hopefully you guys enjoy yourselves. And we'll check you back here next tomorrow night. Twitch.tv, An Actual Gorilla. And you'll find this episode uploaded onto YouTube probably tomorrow. But for now, guys, hope you have a good night. And thanks for tuning in.